In this video, we will talk about another dense connective tissue, that is cartilage. Cartilage is softer and flexible as compared to the bones. But in cartilaginous fishes, it provides the strength. It is the endoskeleton. In case of embryonic stage also, in vertebrates, this cartilaginous endoskeleton is there. And this cartilaginous endoskeleton, then it undergoes ossification where mineral deposition takes place, and then this cartilage would get replaced by the bony structure. So, because it is connective tissue, it would have same two things, that is cells and the matrix. The cells are chondrocytes and chondroblasts. Blast cells are the ones which are going to secrete the matrix. Once they get surrounded by the matrix, they would change into the chondrocytes. And the matrix. Matrix is rubber-like, or it is rubbery, and it has fibers also. Now, if there are fibers, that means there would be fiber-producing cells also. So, that fiber-producing cell is fibroblast. And depending upon which type of fiber is there and how much of that fiber is there, we'll classify this cartilage into various types. So this is rubbery material, fibers are also there, and the complete matrix is actually made up of chondroitin sulfate. Now let us take the structure. The outer part is covered with a fibrous sheath, which is known as perichondrium. And there is nothing inside, as was there in case of the compact bone. So in compact bone, there was an outer layer also and an inner layer also. Here, there's only one layer, that is outer layer. And beneath this layer are these chondroblasts. So these are the chondroblasts. Chondroblast cells, they migrate, they move in, and now they start secreting the matrix around them. Now this is a chondroblast which has come here and it has produced a matrix around it. So now we start calling it chondrocyte. So it is the chondroblast itself which changes into the chondrocytes. These chondrocytes, they may be singly placed or they may be in groups. So there can be two cells together, there can be three cells together, there can be more than three cells also together. And all these chondrocytes, they are placed in a space. And this space is known as lacuna. So these are the lacunae. So all these chondrocytes, they are placed in this fluid-filled cavity, which is lacuna. Fluid-filled cavity, which is lacuna. And normally these chondrocytes are present in groups, but they can be single also, as we have shown here. And now here is all the matrix. Sometimes the matrix is clear without any fiber, glass-like, that is seen in case of hyaline cartilage. And if there are fibers, depending upon which fibers, if there is collagen fiber, then we'll have to draw them in bundles. And if there is elastin fiber, we'll draw this elastin fiber as single branched structure. So this is collagen and this is elastin. Here we have shown everything which is there. And these fibers are secreted by those large irregular cells which are called the fibroblasts. Depending upon what type of matrix is present, there are three types of cartilages. And these three types are hyaline cartilage. Then there is fibrocartilage. And third is known as elastin cartilage. We will talk about the detailed structure of all these three in the next part. But what exactly is hyaline cartilage? It is glass-like, more or less translucent. There are no fibers. Fibrocartilage is tough. It has mainly collagen fibers. And sometimes it is also known as white fibrous cartilage because of the presence of collagen. So we can also call it white fibrous cartilage. And elastin cartilage, as the name tells us, it has more of elastin fibers. So this is flexible and elastic due to presence of the elastin fibers. So in the next part, we will take up all these three cartilages, their locations and their structure. But cartilage as a tissue, as a connective tissue, has same things with minor differences. Chondroblasts are going to be there, chondrocytes are also going to be there. Arrangement is same. If fiber is present, we would have more of fibroblasts. And if it is like hyaline cartilage, fibroblasts are going to be very, very less. As we have drawn these chondroblasts at only one place, that means new cells are going to get added from this side. So, in case of cartilage, growth is unidirectional. If you remember, we said in bones, the growth is bidirectional because there were those osteoblasts on both the sides. Here, the chondroblasts are only on one side. Another important thing, there is no blood vessel or nerve in the cartilage. Then how do these cells receive the nourishment or gases for respiration? Nourishment and respiratory gases diffuse up to the cells. So there is no blood vessel and no nerves. So cells receive nutrition and oxygen by diffusion. So there must be a place where this nutrition and oxygen are reaching, and they reach only perichondrium. So perichondrium is supplied with blood vessels and nerves. So here the nourishment reaches, and from here it's going to diffuse to all the cells. So growth of cartilage is unidirectional because the making cells, that is chondroblasts, they are present only on the outer side. Now in the next part, we'll take up these three cartilages in detail. We'll study their structure and discuss their locations also.